So we have the last two conference champs going out of here tonight, Petros.
Yeah, two really well-coached teams. Going to be fun here in the cold.
And the first kick of the game returned by Isaac Jernigan to the 20-yard line. Good coverage by that Utah State coverage unit. And we get our first look at the man who could be the offensive player of the year in the Mountain West, Chevin Cordero. The Hawaii transfer, 14 touchdown passes, just three interceptions. He gets it done through the air and with his feet. Very, very dangerous.
And he started fast in some games. He's had some struggles, in particular against Fresno State and San Diego State, but he has been electric.
Cordero going to the air. Justin Lockhart hauling it in. First play and big gain for the Spartans. Andre Grayson on the stop. We look at this Spartan offense. They've given up 34 sacks as the offensive line in nine games. So they're trying to improve on that tonight. At the running back position, Kyrie Robinson is the man that they lean on.
Ball start, number 70, offense. 5-yard penalty, remain first down.
And that's Malik Williams, who is starting at left guard. Jaime Navarro, normally the left guard, moves over to right guard for this one. And this Aggies defense, they have some tough guys up front. Greshick, Vaughn certainly leading the way. A lot of experience there between those two defensive ends. San Jose State keeping it on the ground and then wrapped up. Greshick, first man there for that Aggie defense.
Kyrie Robinson's a guy they like to get the ball to. That's his 108th carry of the year, but they just want to run it a little bit and then distribute with Cordero. Greshick, another one of those Nevada transfers with a great tackle. Nevada transfers on both these teams.
Second and 14 from the 35. Cordero rolling to his right. Pass complete to Lockhart again. He has some room down to the 40-yard line. A.J. Bavong-Pichong, the leading tackler for the Aggies, there to make the stop, but not after another big game.
Yeah, another Nevada transfer, this time for the Spartans. Lockhart with his second catch, doing a good job stopping in that zone, and Cordero on the run, throws beautifully on the run, finds him right between the two ones, and Lockhart creates down the field. Great start offensively for the Spartans. This is how they started against San Diego State.
Cordero with two completions over 20 yards already. The last one goes for 23.
This is the man, Elijah Cooks, out on the edge, 6'4", one of the best looking receivers in the West.
Keeping it on the ground with Robinson. Utah State trying to string it out. Robinson used the stiff arm to pick up a couple. It's Andre Grayson finally getting him out of bounds after a gain of five.
Yeah, he really kind of got tossed into the Maverick Stadium sideline at the end. Ike Larson comes pretty late and launches him into that bench and greaseboard.
This is a big game for both of these teams. Certainly a lot of emotion on senior night for Utah State. Ike Larson, just a redshirt freshman, but you can make a case for him being one of the best defensive players on the team this year. He has been outstanding, especially as of late, the reigning Mountain West Conference Defensive Player of the Week. Second and three now for the Spartans. Cordero up the left sideline, and the catch is made. Elijah Cooks, you referenced him just a moment ago, Petros. Good coverage, able to haul it in for the score. A 36-yard touchdown.
Well, this is not what you wanted to see if you're Blake Anderson and the Aggies playing at home, but look at him working on the edge against Andre Grayson, who just was involved in the play, pushing Robinson out of bounds, and he is there, but he never gets his head around. And then Cooks is able just to go up and make the catch, doesn't even high point it because Grayson wasn't looking. Whoa!
And the kick is blocked. So Utah State able to hold him to just six. I believe that was Ike Larson getting a hand on it. Let's take another look. No, it was Big 94, Tavian Coleman from his defensive tackle spot. Larson has two blocked punts this year, but not able to get there from the edge.
Yeah, he just goes straight up and gets a mid on it. And usually those point after tries get popped up really high, and it's hard to get them at the line of scrimmage because the ball has so much elevation. Not on that one, though.
So how about Cordero, Pete? Completions of 20-23, and then just drops this one in the bucket from 36 yards out.
Came out firing, and like we said, Grayson never really got his head around. And the transfer from Nevada, along with Lockhart, goes up and makes a great play. He's Shevin's roommate, so hopefully no arguments. He's getting the ball early.
Short kick from Shiva, hauled in at about the 24-yard line, out to the 30. That was the tight end, Brock Lane. So Cooper Laga making his sixth start for the Aggies. We mentioned that quarterback carousel. They played four different quarterbacks. Logan Bonner started the season. Laga came in. Then he had a concussion. Levi Williams, the Wyoming transfer, injured his ankle against Colorado State. Bishop Davenport got a start. Now it's back to Laga, and they're starting to find a groove a little bit.
And he's the guy. If it's not going to be Bonner, Cooper Laga is the quarterback of the future. He played great in the L.A. Bowl, led them to a victory over Oregon State last bowl season. He's back and playing well.
Keeping it on the ground with their shifty running back, Calvin Tyler. This offensive line for Utah State has been rapidly improving. They did have a rough go of it against Hawaii. As you look at the skill players, and there's some good ones here. Lada feeling the pressure, he's gonna tuck it and run. Slides just shy of the 40-yard line. And when you talk about this Spartans defense, man, up front, they have some monsters. We talked about them in the open, the linebackers. Paced by Kyle Harmon, the youngster Brian Parham making some moves in the secondary. They have some playmakers as well. This is not an easy defense to move the ball on. Utah State obviously going to try to do that with number four there, Calvin Tyler, who's coming off a 113-yard performance. Playing a little tempo here. Laga on first down. Quick completion out to Terrell Vaughn.
This is a fast offense, and they will play as fast as they possibly can. Bishop Davenport, the freshman, even had a moving with pace, but they have a lot more of a chance to really run it the way Anthony Tucker, the OC, wants them to run it, with Cooper Laga at the controls.
Second and one, four-man rush from the Spartans. Laga with time, moving around in the pocket just a bit. Able to hold on. McGriff was wide open, had it for a moment, and then lost the handle.
First of all, Laga so still in the pocket, and then is able to get that ball to McGriff right in his hands, away from his body. McGriff got a big body, 6'6", 215-pound guy. Had a tough drop to create a third and one situation for the Aggies. But Calvin Tyler getting some positive yards early, playing well. He's really been their most consistent offensive player this year, set up for a pretty makeable moment here.
Third and one, Laga gonna keep it himself. And it does look like he picked up the first down for the Aggies. Cooper Laga coming into the game with just shy of 200 yards on the ground, couple of rushing touchdowns, so he's an athlete. He can certainly move.
He can, and they like him tough, but sometimes he gets a little too tough. That's why he was out with a concussion earlier in the year.
Pressure coming up the middle. Laga just has to get rid of it. And that's one of the great things about this San Jose defense is they can get pressure without blitzing.
They have the guys. They have Cade Hall, Fajoco, Lando Gray holding it down. as the nose guard.
Second and 10 from the 49. Lega looking to the right side. Again, that is complete. And again, it's a first down. It's Cobbs hauling it in for Utah State.
Cobbs, a fine transfer from Maryland, has really kind of added to what they do on the perimeter.
And here's Tyler, breaks out of a tackle in the backfield and not able to get a whole lot there. Chase Williams finally with the stop from his safety spot. And if you're just joining us here on Fox Sports 1, Dan Helly, Petros Papadakis, Dean Blandino, our rules expert with us as well. And San Jose State out to the early lead. They scored a touchdown, had the extra point blocked. Lega with time, and he's picked off. Lega picked off by Trey Jenkins, the tone setter in the back end for the San Jose State defense, and already a big play for the senior from Stockton, California.
Lega floats it up there, and Trey Jenkins, deeply committed to this San Jose State defense, steps in front and makes the play.
The young quarterback with the turnover here, trying to find Terrell Vaughn. Instead, it's Trey Jenkins, San Jose State. Good field position. Man from St. Louis High School in Hawaii. Second and two, Kyrie Robinson. Aside Cordero at running back. Trying to set up the screen to Cooks. But there was good coverage there.
Yeah, and if you're going to throw a middle screen where that receiver is coming back across the formation and you expect him to get behind blockers and get upfield, that ball's got to be on his chest. Even though Cooks is a long guy, that's putting him at risk. Third and short here after that Cordero run on first down.
Third and two now for the junior from Hawaii. Cordero caught, first down, Cooks. He uses that big body nicely. And it was Anyawu in coverage, but not a whole lot he can do there.
Yeah, he's got a club on his arm and a beautiful back shoulder throw by Cordero. Getting Cooks involved early and often in this one.
15-yard gain for Cooks. Two catches, 51 yards. From the 40, and unable to hold on is Jackson Kanan.
Jackson Kanan in the game because they don't have Sam Olsen and Dominique Mazzotti as Cooks looks on. We were talking to their offensive coordinator, Kevin McGivin, about the different weapons they have. There's Kanan. And they don't really try to get the ball to anybody as far as targets go, except for Cooks. Everybody else is just within the flow of the offense. But Cooks is a guy they have to single out.
Tripped up right at the line of scrimmage is Kyrie Robinson. Motuakapaka from that defensive tackle spot got a hand on him. And, you know, Robinson is, you said they try to run just enough, which is absolutely right, but so important in terms of wins and losses, averaging over 5 yards per carry in wins, about 3 yards per carry in losses. So if they can get him going, really elevates this offense.
If your linebackers are watching him, Cordero has more room to work and distribute, and that's really the offense.
Third and 10. Cordero lets it go behind the intended receiver, Justin Lockhart. So after the turnover, San Jose State unable to turn it into points. And Travis Benham will be on to punt to Cooper Jones. And when it's 23 degrees outside near the quarterback, you head to the sideline and put that coat on. Jones going to let it bounce, and it takes a friendly Spartan bounce. They down it at the 3-yard line. Isaac Jernigan is there. Got the ski goggles on, you got the blanket wrapping you up. Good times here at Maverick Stadium. Although the Aggies find themselves down 6-0. If you joined us a little bit late, this is how we got points on the board. Just a beautiful pass from Chevin Cordero to his go-to wide receiver, Elijah Cooks. His 6th touchdown catch of the year. At 6'4", he just goes up and gets that perfect throw as well. The extra point was blocked, so now it's Utah State's turn from their own 3-yard line, keeping it on the ground. And good way to start with Calvin Tyler. And they were moving the ball in that first drive, ran 10 plays, picked up 3 first downs before the interception from Cooper Laga. Trey Jenkins stepped in front of it.
And you see,
second pick of the year. Sorry, Petros.
You see how big of a factor Tyler is going to be running the ball in this game, and Cooper Laga's legs running in this game, also huge for Utah State's offense. They're going to need to pull out a lot of stuff to compete with this San Jose State offense and try to keep up scoring points.
Here he is again, and there's just nowhere to go against that defense. Cade Hall making the tackle, as he has done so often throughout his career.
Trying to get it to Tyler on an inside run, and he kind of pauses.
Quick game, and nearly intercepted again. It was a tip drill. Chase Williams couldn't quite hold on to it.
There's a flag down. Terrell Vaughn had a couple of hands on the ball and popped it up in the air for Chase Williams, as
legal
he said.
Substitution on defense, 12 men on the field, 5-yard penalty, replay, third down.
12 guys, and they still couldn't come up with the pick. Laga really floating it up there, and yeah, no real chance for Vaughn there. Only one hand on it. It was a little bit behind him as well.
So 3rd and 2 from the 12. Laga somehow eludes the tackler, lets it go, and was he able to go down and get it? We do have a flag down. It was Brock Lane. Don't know if he got his hands underneath that one.
Laga gets away.
Elijah Wood looked like he had him wrapped up.
He ducked out of that with strength and dexterity.
And that was on downfield, number 72, defense. 5-yard from previous spot, replay, third down.
Alfred Edwards got downfield because the timing of the play got all screwed up with Laga. It's over here, downfield, yeah. And he's going to just keep on trying to block downfield. The play timing was all screwed up with the Elijah Wood pressure.
So now 3rd and 7 from the 7.
Tough spot early in this game for the Aggies. They need to get out of the shadow of this end zone.
And a couple of off-the-mark throws from Cooper Laga has that early interception. Again, making just his 6th career start. The junior from Orem, Utah.
5:50 on the clock. 5:50.
All right, resetting the clock from 5:37 to 5:50. As both head coaches looking on. And Brent Brennan is about as happy a head coach as you'll talk to.
Well, he's a really positive guy, and he's really pushed this San Jose State football team forward through a lot of adversity. with positivity. Going back for a few years, he's a local guy, and he's given his heart and soul to the Spartans.
McGaugh lets it go and completes it to the 35-yard line. Brian Cobbs hauls in the dart.
And he has got that element to his game. He can throw some fastballs, or as you said, a dart. Nice break by Cobbs and making that play and catching it in stride going upfield.
Fresh set of downs, another quick pass. It's Brock Lane. Hit right away, and you can see that the Aggies love to run tempo.
Brock Lane involved in this game early, was involved last week. Second target from McGaugh.
Another quick pass, it's Vaughn.
The last pass is
Vaughn out to the 43-yard line, picking up a first down for Utah State before he shoved out of bounds by Dansby.
Yeah, and he fought for that first down. Could have caught the ball and gotten out of bounds, but broke a tackle and fell forward for the first down. And Utah State playing scrappy offense right now, getting out from that dangerous area and putting together a bit of a drive here.
That's Viliami Fahoko. We're going to take a quick break. We're back in Logan after this. Welcome back to Logan. Time to take a look at the keys to the game presented by Target. What we value most shouldn't cost more. What do you have, Pete?
Well, for the Spartans, they got to employ the Mike DeMone from Fast Times at Ridgemount High attitude. Wherever you are, that's the place to be. You got to deal with this weather and handle it and be dynamic. For Utah State, they need to get tricky. They've really been decimated by injuries. To keep up with this offense, they've got to throw everything at the wall and see what sticks. And Blake Anderson told us all about that. They have got a playbook full of tricks. We'll see if they pull any out.
This drive started on their own 4-yard line with 7:05 left in the first quarter. Done a nice job moving the ball so far. Here's Tyler spinning out of one tackle, but not another. Sewanee Toya, all 290 pounds of him, make sure that he's not going far.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy for Tyler. They have some great run stoppers for the Spartans. Kyle Harmon there as well, really kind of the leader.
Four-man rush, they're getting through. McGaugh able to get rid of it. And the catch is made. Lando Gray was giving chase. Sturzer hauls it in. Third down and about 3.
Good job by McGaugh just to find Sturzer there, as Lando Gray was really bearing down on him, as you mentioned, setting up this makeable third down situation. Look for him to maybe run it.
McGaugh, quick pass. Again, it's Sturzer right at the sticks.
Sturzer, a junior out of Salt Lake City, 6'3". Listed as a tight end, lined up outside. Takes a pretty big hit from Shelton, but hangs on.
Quick pass out to Cobbs. Andrew Jenkins slow to get up on the sideline.
They are really using that tempo and trying to tax the Spartans' defense. Coach Anderson really has that ability, but it's got to be a culture you live year-round playing with this kind of tempo and being ready at the line of scrimmage.
Second down, another quick pass, another first down, Utah State. Cobbs catches, makes a quick spin move, gets just enough. Nehemiah Shelton not able to stop until after he picks up the first.
Well, right now the Aggies and Anthony Tucker, their OC, is seeing a big cushion there with Shelton on the edge, and they just continue to throw it as long as that cushion is there, as he's walking up a little bit now. But there's been a big cushion, and they've exploited it. 3 plays in a row.
Under 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. The 11th play of the drive coming up. Tyler keeping those feet moving. Might have picked up 2 before Kyle Harmon gets to him. Tyler coming into this game, 853 yards on the ground, 3 touchdowns.
He's really come into his own.
to his left. And, man, he is on target. Another one to Terrell Vaughn.
Cooper Laga is sharp with these short passes early, really delivering the ball. Looked like Jacob South, the right tackle, was down there. Popped back up, and they're back running tempo again. You see the first downs that Utah State's put together here toward the end of the first quarter.
Eight first downs and the first two drives of the game for Utah State. 10 of 13 for Laga. Set to throw again, looks right. He's going to keep it this time on his own. Inside the 20-yard line, down to the 15. Run out of bounds by Harmon.
You saw him think about it. He wanted to lower that shoulder, but they are trying to get him to be a little bit more cautious with his body and throwing it around. We talked about his wrestling prowess in high school and what a tough guy he is. Nice scramble on first down, setting up an ahead-of-the-sticks play call here.
Gonna throw again. Pressure coming from the Spartans. And nearly picked off in the end zone. It was Nehemiah Shelton, hit him right between the numbers, and he couldn't hold on.
Laga so sharp. And this is hard, you know, you take off on a run, you're moving around, and then you drop back again, and you're expected to throw it accurately. That's just modern-day quarterbacking, and that one sails on him way over the head of Brian Cobbs, and I think it surprised Shelton, hit him right in the breadbasket.
It was the first...
But he's got that club.
It was the first incompletion of the drive for Laga. He was 8 for 8 since that interception. Tyler. Wiggling his way through and busted into the end zone. Give him 6. A 96-yard scoring drive for the Aggies.
What an impactful drive here at home in the cold. Tyler, like you said, just kind of picks his way through and wiggles out. He's got really good acceleration when he sees the goal line. Elijah Wood is the guy that kind of slid off his back and allowed him to score.
Connor Coles from Bozeman, Montana, on for the extra point. And Utah State marches 96 yards in just over 6 minutes to take the lead. Heck of a first quarter already. Welcome back. FS1 College Football, sponsored by Chase Sapphire. Make more of what's yours. What a scoring drive for Utah State. Started on their own 4-yard line. They marched 96 yards down the field, chew up over 6 minutes of clock. Calvin Tyler, their senior running back from Beaumont, Texas, hits Pater. And with the extra point, they now have a 7-6 lead over the visiting San Jose State Spartans. Elliot Nimrod kicking to Isaac Jernigan. And if you were wondering what this number 6 was on the side of the Utah State players' helmets, they are honoring Camden McWright, who was a freshman running back for San Jose State. He died tragically a month ago in an electric scooter accident. He was hit riding the scooter when he was just a couple of blocks from campus. And flowers were laid at the 6-yard line to remember McWright, a great kid, a 4.0 student, just a tragic, tragic loss and a tough time for this Spartan football team.
Cordero's pass is complete.
And Jermaine Braddock hauls in the Cordero pass. As San Jose State, we know they can get going in a hurry.
And both these offenses are showing a little bit of a fire early in this game. Quarterbacks distributing the ball and getting after it. San Jose State, you're wondering why you couldn't pick that ball off in the end zone.
Oh, man, it was right there. And then they had the other pick and couldn't turn that into points. So a couple of missed opportunities there for the Spartans. The pitch outside to Robinson. Robinson going to get out past the 40 going to be just shy of picking up the first down before he's run out of bounds by Hunter Reynolds.
And that is exactly the kind of running they need on first down. They run a little pitch play. They get him out to the edge. Good job by Malik Williams getting out and making a block and moving that big body. And Robinson with a quick 8 yards on first down as the first quarter comes to an end.
It's a one-point game at Maverick Stadium in Logan, Utah. The conference champs from last year, the conference champs from the year before. A couple of great offenses and great defenses going at it. What a first year for Blake Anderson and for San Jose State. The year prior is what he was trying to do. He got that done in his first year for Utah State. So back-to-back champs on the field here tonight. Utah State getting it done last year. San Jose State done the year before. Look at the first quarter numbers. And we have had some sudden change plays. This is not one of them. Nowhere to go for Kyrie Robinson. We mentioned how important it is to get the run game going. Last week in that loss to San Diego State, 9 carries for just 32 yards.
He got swallowed up there by Tavian Coleman. Big sophomore playing defensive tackle.
Sets up 3rd and 2. To find Isaac Jernigan.
They ran a wheel route with Jernigan and he was wide open, and Cordero threw it on a line, which I believe was the right throw to get it to him right away, because that's how wide open he was. And I think Jernigan expected it to be popped up or kind of laid into his hand. What a missed opportunity.
Cooper Jones back to receive the punt. Gonna let it bounce, and then he jumps on it. Risky play there. Jernigan was down there right as Jones was trying to re-corral the ball, and he's able to hold on to it. Wow, dangerous play here, Petros.
Ball handling in this game, whether it's been interceptions or stuff like that, or this muffed punt, has been an adventure. Fortunate for the Aggies to come up with that. Weir loves it.
Wow. So here's Cooper Laga, who has completed 10 of 14 passes. Looked really good on that last drive. Did have that interception on the first drive.
And a near one on the last one. But he's played with fire and purpose.
Quarterback draw for Laga, and he's popped right about the 19-yard line. Big hit. Marcel Sanders was there, and Kyle Harmon got to him as well.
Yeah, Jacob South never even got out of his stance, the right tackle. So very interesting miscommunication with the Aggies offensive line, and they still turned something positive out of it. There's South. Kyle Harmon with a tough hit on Laga at the end of that.
Vaughn in motion, Wilmore the back. Another quick pass behind Cobbs. That brings up 3rd and 6. Laga gets into a rhythm,
yeah.
Gets going, and then he hits the skids.
Yeah, we've seen a couple of very accurate throws from him, and this offense really working on time when they're running tempo. But it feels like the longer they have to think about it, sometimes these passes become a little bit less catchable.
3rd and 6 here. Clean pocket until now. Down goes Laga. Cade Hall wraps him up for the sack for Hall. That's now 7.5 sacks on the season.
The great Cade Hall, the graduate. Just swallowing him up because he took too long to think about it, ultimately beating Alfred Edwards, but that ball probably should have been out. Cade Hall's been a longtime cornerstone on this defense.
Nimrod on to punt. Isaiah Hamilton deep for the Spartans. Hamilton catches it at the 50 and he's hit. The official looking for his flag and mixing it up just a little bit.
Oh, there is a flag.
Yeah. Took him a second to pull it out. It's 23 degrees. He had his gloves on. Probably, you know, couldn't get the flag right away.
Still sorting it out, huh?
Kick catch interference on the kicking team. 15 yards from the spot. All right, first down. Timeout on the field.
So fair catch called for. Illegal contact is made. And we are back. It's a one-point ball game here in the second quarter. FS1 College Football is sponsored by Chase Sapphire. Make more of what's yours. All right, a look at the Mountain West Conference standings. Boise State remains perfect in conference. They come back to beat Wyoming. That is a big one there. San Diego State, of course, a big winner over New Mexico last night.
How would you know?
You and I might have had a thing or two to do with that game. What is going on?
Number 55, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Wow, they both go down there.
Jeez.
Double splash here. Let's see what Cordero does with the clap. Oh, wow.
You don't see that very often.
No. Nobody even pushed him. Malik Williams and James McNorton both at the same time. Double up.
Cordero. Wrapped up, and that is right away Motu Apuaka with his third sack of the year, the World Fire Knife champion, answering the call for the Aggie defense.
He does a good job just fighting and fighting and getting his hands on Cordero through the block of Navarro.
Second and 24 now for San Jose State. Cordero. Gonna go down again. This time it's Greshick. Utah State sack leader with sack number 6. Back-to-back sacks for the Aggie defense. Sets up third and 27.
Another Nevada transfer. There he is on the edge with the bull rush against McNorton. And then, just like the previous play, gets his hands on Cordero. Back-to-back sacks. Utah State slowly starting to take some control here. They can get their offense going, and Lagarde just a little bit more consistent.
Just going to keep it on the ground and try to get some of those yards back with Robinson. But we have a flag down. Looked like they were being pretty aggressive. Fernando Carmona, I believe, is going to be called for that penalty. He's the left tackle for San Jose State.
Yeah, he went flying in there with aggression, and that's a 6'5", about 270-pound guy. Looked like a little bit after the whistle. There you see Robinson finishing the run physically over Hunter Reynolds and then coming in late and blowing everybody up, especially Dominique Tatum, is Carmona.
The play, personal foul, late hit, number 79 offense. 15 yards, fourth down.
That hurts you in the field position battle you're trying to play, but remember, San Jose State pinned Utah State back, and they had a 96-yard drive to answer in the first quarter.
So that's the third penalty on the San Jose State offensive line, and they did do some shuffling on the offensive line shortly before the game.
Not a great series for them. No. You got the false start, two sacks in a row, and then the late hit.
And
wow.
This is getting interesting here. You don't want to go anywhere. We're going to be back in Logan right after this. It has been a quarterback carousel for Utah State. Logan Bonner, who led them to the Mountain West Championship last year, hurt early in the season. Cooper Laga replaces him, but then gets a concussion. He's replaced for a while by Levi Williams, the Wyoming transfer. He gets hurt, and then Bishop Davenport, the freshman, comes in, starts against Wyoming. Then Laga is healthy and back. There are the numbers for Logan Bonner, who was spectacular for the Aggies last year during the Mountain West Conference Championship season. He is very involved in the offense and has been around quite a bit as Nine Davis picks up the first down and then some.
They bring Davis all the way out to the edge. A little bit of a reverse look as Logan Bonner looks on. You know you're important if you get to wear a headset.
There is a flag down in the defensive backfield.
But they had kind of a double move set up for Brock Lane, and Laga just kind of threw it out of bounds. Two tight ends out there, Sturzer and Lane, and Sturzer with a hold there on Shelton. I think that drew the flag.
Number 83, offense. 10 yards from previous spot, replay, second down.
Yep, you spotted it, Petros.
It looked like they were set up for a double move or the play.
Second and 11. Lagarde complete, it's Cobb, breaks a tackle, plus territory. Finally wrangled down by Chase Williams. See why he's so dangerous.
This was an accurate throw. Here's Cobbs. He's going to get in that zone, turn around, and Kyle Harmon's going to harass him, trying to get after him, but he wiggles away.
Tyler. And we have a flag down as Tyler cuts against the grain. It's a fantastic run. I don't know if it's going to count, however.
Yeah, he's getting more and more patient
holding
and creative.
Number 61, offense. 10 yards from the previous spot, replay, first down.
Lapuaho, the right guard, called for the hold in his 11th career start. There he is.
Two holding calls for Utah State on this drive.
Penalties have become a bit of a story as this game has kind of settled into a rhythm. Penalties have made it less rhythmic.
Keeping on the ground. Wrapped up right away, Lando Gray.
Good job by the graduate, Lando Gray, the nose guard. Usually a guy like that, 300-pound guy, gets his hands on you around the line of scrimmage like he did Calvin Tyler there. You're not going to go too much further.
Second and 16. Under 10 to go here in the first half. Three wide receivers to the left for Cooper Laga. Keeping on the ground with Tyler again. Nice run by Tyler. Going to be third and medium now. That's a gain of 8.
I like the way he doesn't give up on a hole. A lot of the times backs will see a little bit of traffic and they'll bounce it outside, but Tyler does a great job of staying patient and finding nooks and crannies like an English muffin to get up into the line of scrimmage and find positive yardage. That was a good run.
That was a good line. Like an English muffin. Calvin Tyler, 5 100-yard games on the season coming in. 9 career games over the 100-yard mark. 3rd and 8 here. Play clock winding down. They get it off, quick pass to Cobbs. Cobbs has room. Cobbs leaps a tackler, and he's inside the 30-yard line.
Great timing on this play. Cobbs is going to make the play, gets a good block from Lane, and then Big Jacob South coming out there and setting a big block, the right tackle, and then the leap on Chase Williams. Beautiful.
There's Tyler, man, he just keeps those legs moving. You can see Fajoko just trying to wrestle him down, but it's like a bull coming out of the gates there.
He's taken big steps this year. He's a lot more in shape, plays better in the altitude. There's a guy that doesn't come out either, Junior Fajoko.
Second and three all day. The dog gonna run it. And it's a hurdling competition out here for the Aggies. Dangerous play for your quarterback.
Laga has such a weird style because he just stands so still in the pocket. Lando Gray lost the whole play. And yeah, flying through the air around the line of scrimmage. Like a gymnast.
Going to the end zone. And that'll bring up second down. He was looking for Cobbs.
Look at the stillness in the pocket from Laga. And look at Lando Gray just lose him. Has no idea where he is. He's just out there looking around. And Laga then decides to take off and takes off.
Talk about Laga being an athlete. Six-time state champion, a couple of state championships in football, two in the javelin and two in wrestling.
The javelin?
Yeah, if he would have run the hurdles, I'm sure he would have had one in that too. Second and 10. Laga quick pass out to Cobbs. Cobbs met by Dansby. And that brings up third down.
I mean, we saw this team with Bishop Davenport, the freshman, true freshman, as a starter at Wyoming. And this offense, Blake Anderson's offense, run by Anthony Tucker, just looks a lot different with Cooper Laga under center. And it looked even crazy with Logan Bonner, though he wasn't as much of a runner, more of a distributor with the ball. I like Laga. He plays with a lot of violence and purpose.
Timeout, Utah State. Third and 7 coming up. Utah State on the move behind quarterback Cooper Laga. We're back after this. It is almost time. The 2022 FIFA World Cup starts tomorrow. And on Monday, Christian Pulisic and Team USA played their opener against Wales. Coverage starts at 1 Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. On Fox, and you can win $1 million. Fill out your World Cup bracket right now at foxsports.com/bracket, and you can play for free with a chance to win $1 million. Who doesn't want to do that? How about this, man? In terms of plays and time of possession, Utah with a distinct advantage over San Jose State, but Utah State with just a 1-point lead. This the 10th play of the drive coming up. Laga gonna keep it himself inside the 5-yard line. Brian Parnum finally knocking him out of bounds. Gonna be shy of picking up the first. So 4th and 1 coming up from the 5.
Yeah, Ali'i Matau came over and he looked like he was pretty hemmed up, and then he took the edge and got a lot more than I thought he would. Making a decision here is Blake Anderson because of that run by Cooper Laga on the quarterback draw. He can create and make things happen. He's shifty.
They're going to go for it. Tyler on 4th down. Picks up the first. And a fresh set of downs inside the 5-yard line for Utah State.
They're just holding on to the ball and sitting on it, really taking a lot of the air out of it with the short passing and the running with Tyler Jr., and that keeps Cordero on the sideline.
Here's Tyler again doing a little dance, and in the end zone, Utah State with their 2nd touchdown of the night. Calvin Tyler now 53 yards and two touchdowns with 5.5 to go in the first half.
Two Tyler touchdowns, and those celebrations will help warm up the fans at Maverick Stadium. He's just really done a great job of being patient. Sturzer leads through, doesn't see anything there, bounces it over to the left. Runs right through Dansby to score.
Pulls on for the extra point and going for it on fourth and one pays dividends. For the second time tonight, Calvin Tyler finding Pater. Aggies rolling.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime, TCU barely survives to remain unbeaten. Ohio State and Michigan remain on a collision course. And number one Georgia, they just keep on winning. Dan and Petros, it's back to you.
Acho, thank you very much. Fans starting to get into it here after the second touchdown from Calvin Tyler in this game at Maverick Stadium. And they're just chewing up clock, a couple of touchdown drives. Over 5 minutes, and the kickoff out of bounds by Nimrod.
Kick out of bounds, kick a team. Ball placed at the 35-yard line, first down.
So when you look at this offense for San Jose State, they came into the game fourth in the conference, averaging 27 points per game, but we know they can be explosive. We've seen them be explosive.
Seen it tonight with those, look at that average on the throws, 20-yard average, but they haven't had enough of it. And like we've said, they've been getting cold on that sideline watching Utah State move the ball slowly.
Cordero trying to squeeze it in to Justin Lockhart, but it was Xavier Steele there, really good coverage.
And this is Utah State's plan. Hold the ball and then find a way to get off the field quickly against this explosive Spartans offense. And setting up a second and 10, getting a hand in there is a great way to get it started. We saw Lockhart really moving early in this game, but haven't heard much from these guys. They've been watching on the sideline.
Second and 10, Cordero gonna keep it on his own. Can he find the corner?
On the keeper, number two.
Cordero picks up 5 on the keeper. It was Hunter Reynolds who runs him out of bounds.
And this is really the deciding factor when things get rough for San Jose State. If they're having trouble offensively, Cordero's gotta get things going with his legs and find some more manageable down and distance situations. That time setting up this 3rd and 4. They've got to get it, though. Their defense is going to be tired.
Shamar Garrett checking into the game at running back. Four-man rush from the Aggies. And they're not going to get it. Larson coming in to make the tackle and prevent San Jose State from picking up the first down.
Mike Larson, who's really come up, he's become a starter. Mountain West Defensive Player of the Week, Mountain West Freshman of the Week versus Hawaii. Very productive, and that time making a great tackle, denying the first down to the Spartans.
Alex Weir with the punt, fair catch called for at the 20. And it's the Aggie defense that's making a statement here in the first half.
Don't sweat the
Aggie ball coming up. Yeah. There's all Petros' buddies.
Yeah, I love these guys.
Temps dropping 20 degrees at Maverick Stadium now. It is, it's getting cold, P.
I like the extra friend that put the bowl on. You know, he showed up later and they put the bowl on his chest. And there's the Yeti. Blue cheese, aged to perfection.
See what Utah State can do here after a couple of touchdown drives that have eaten up over 11 minutes of clock combined. Nice swing out there to Josh Sturzer, pick up a couple. just over 4 minutes. They'll continue to run tempo that's worked so well for them here in the first half.
Yeah, the Spartans are keeping stuff in front of them. And if you do that, you're asking the offense to kind of dink and dunk their way down and not make a mistake. And the Aggies have been able to do that.
Vaughn breaks one tackle, picks up two. Chase Williams, one of the guys there, bringing up third down.
Now, here's the thing. When you run a tempo offense, they've just run two plays in blinding speed, and here they have a third down situation. So they've got to get the play called right, and they've got to find a way to stay on the field, because you don't want to have it be this kind of three and out, not with the momentum that they've created. So they take a little bit more time with the third down and shorter.
Third and three, Legat hit right as he throws, and then Cobbs falls down. That'll bring up fourth down.
Yeah, they've had so much success with Calvin Tyler and the run game. They go away from it this time. San Jose State dials up some pressure with Chase Williams, and he almost gets there, and that's what forced the errant throw, a bit of a bump there at the end, but I don't think it matters. He was throwing it out of bounds, it looked like.
Steven Kotzenle on to punt for Utah State. And after those long drives, Utah State had the ball for just 68 seconds there. Fair catch called for at the 25 by Isaiah Hamilton. Tomorrow on Fox, Saquon Barkley and the Giants looking to continue their surprisingly successful season as they take on the Lions. Or Justin Fields quickly becoming a must-watch in the NFL as the quarterback for the Bears. They're taking on the Falcons. Check out your local listings for the game in your area only on Fox and the Fox Sports app. So that first drive resulted in a touchdown for the Spartans, but since then, four punts.
It came out hot, and now they've cooled off, quite literally, standing on the sideline watching Utah State's offense work, but three and out, they get the ball right back.
Cordero gonna take a shot here, and almost making the catch was Elijah Cooks, but you could see he got there early. Xavien Steele kind of wrapped them up before the ball got there.
Yeah, Xavien Steele looked like he knew he was beaten, and he did not want Cooks to make this catch and take it to the end zone and watch him celebrate. So he just tries to pull his arms down. Cooks is such a good athlete with body control, he almost comes up with it.
Pass interference, number seven, defense. 15 yards from previous spot, automatic first down.
And that's the most momentum the Spartans have had in a little bit of a while. Let's see if they can capitalize on this. Their defense gave them a stop and really changed things around. Start was great. Can they finish the first half the way they started with a touchdown?
Cordero flushed out of the pocket.
Cordero on the keeper.
And he'll pick up a couple. It was Grezik who was chasing him. And check this out last week. Elijah Cooks, one of the sickest catches that you will see early against San Diego State. My goodness, spinning around, off balance, has to climb the ladder to go get it. Gets plenty of feet in bounds. You only need one in college, though. You got three or four to.
You can see why they throw it up to him and let him work, and that's why he's a guy that they like to target, make sure they try to get him the ball.
Cordero swings it out quickly to Robinson as Carter has a conversation with him as he hits him on his way out of bounds, both of them smiling a little bit.
Carter's been out about a month, and he's been day-to-day with a foot, so they're happy to have him back.
Yeah, they weren't sure he was going to play tonight.
Yeah, looks pretty good there, and excited to be back out on the field.
Carter smiling as he goes to the sideline. Third and five for the Spartans. Over the head of Jermaine Braddock.
And he had him for the first down on the slant. Braddock was open, and Cordero just not as sharp as he was earlier in this game. Braddock tries to stretch his 6'1" frame out and get it, but just can't do it. And San Jose State cannot capitalize.
Alex Weir's punt is blocked, and it's caught at the 45. And Utah State blocking the punt and taking it to the house. Jaden Smith. What a play by the Aggie special teams. We do have a flag down.
That's Ike Larson, laying down on the field. Crazy play. Ended up being a block punt, but a really short
There's
punt.
There's no foul for roughing the punter as his ball was tipped.
Yeah.
Outcome of the play, it's touchdown.
You can't rough the punter if you hit the punt.
The punt is blocked, almost like a tip. Only goes about 10, 15 yards in the air. Let's see who gets a hand on it.
Everybody looked like Ike Larson. And here's Smith. I mean, he's just a special team zealot on this Utah State team. He's done a lot of that. Played all last year. He's a junior now out of Richmond, Texas. Makes a heads-up play and says, I'm taking this back. I might not be the punt returner, but I am now.
Yeah, he looks pretty good on that one, doesn't he?
Sure does. Great play for the Aggies, getting it any way they can. And we talked about that with Coach Anderson. They weren't sure about their offensive ability or how thin they are on defense or how they were going to score with the Spartans. A punt return after a block punt will get those guys excited. And Coach Anderson.
Yeah, he was celebrating like a champ. That was a heck of a play. Blake Anderson all smiles. They're taking another look at it.
Coach Brennan's got a lot to do here as far as getting his team back. Basically, in the right mindset. As this game has gone on, Utah State has found different ways to control it. And yeah, it didn't look like he stepped out of bounds there at the end.
All right, I want to see if Ike Larson indeed was one of them who got there. So it's 81. And then Larson is there too.
I mean, they really attacked all the personal protectors.
So Ike Larson, by the way, if he did indeed get a hand on that, would be his third blocked punt of the year.
It's been a block party.
Jalen Royals, the wide receiver, the other one who was there, 81. Looks like they're trying to make sure he was in bounds.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown, Utah State.
So it's Ike Larson, a freshman, and Jaden Smith, a junior, helping get it done on senior night here in the first half. Let's bring in our rules expert, Dean Blandino. Dean, what did you see here?
A couple things they were looking at. We had contact with the kicker. The referee announced there was no foul because the ball was tipped. Only the player that tips it can contact the kicker and there be no foul. There were two players. It was 81 and 19. They were looking to see who tipped it. And then also the return, did he step out of bounds? Not enough evidence, I think, on the tip. And it did look like he was in bounds. So the whole call on the field did stand.
Thank you for breaking down that down for us. Dean, great hair flow as always for Dean Blandino.
High.
Yeah.
High hair today.
Yeah, a little higher tonight than the norm, but it always looks good.
Like the Starship Enterprise coming out. Beautiful.
21-6. You got ski goggles. You got shirtless dudes. You have blue cheese. What else have you seen in the stands tonight here at Maverick Stadium?
It's always great. A little cold tonight, no doubt about it. Hurt the attendance a little bit.
There's your guys.
Yeah, the Yeti.
Is that Bigfoot?
The Yeti.
Oh, the Yeti.
If it's white, with the white fur, it's the Yeti.
You established that early. I'd forgotten. With the great eyebrows.
Oh, no. That guy, he's struggling. See, that's the only guy that's not cold.
Elliot Nimrod to kick off for Utah State, and he's having trouble keeping it in bounds.
Kick out of bounds, kicking team. The ball is spotted at the 35-yard line, automatic first down.
There he is. Look at that. You want to stay warm at a cold night.
It looks
get
like
a
he's
Yeti
a
costume.
Marathon.
Yeah, dance like a fool and you'll be great.
I mean, that's just like inhaling icicles right now.
Great dedication to Aggie football.
20 degree weather, absolutely. All right, so 125 for Chevin Cordero and this San Jose State team to try to find the end zone here before we go into the locker room at halftime. Catch is made. Lockhart keeping his feet in bounds.
They've been able to get started on drives and get Cordero on the move and delivering the ball. They just haven't had the consistency since their opening drive. Mike Larson, yeah, down again.
If he's just cramping up.
Yeah, it looks like it.
That's good.
You know, you see the cramps usually in late August, week zero, September, in the heat. Larson cramping up in the cold.
20 degrees, huh?
Yeah. He's a local guy, Smithfield, Utah. Used to playing in this kind of weather. Got that big knee brace on.
Skyview High School in Smithfield. Four interceptions this year, leads the team. Had two last week, including a 36-yard pick six in that win over Hawaii. Second and four. Pocket collapsing on Cordero.
Cordero's pass.
And he's able to deliver the completion. No, not able to hold on. Jackson Kanan. Not able to get it. It was Okiki who was there in coverage. So third and four coming up. Here's another look.
Yeah, he goes down to get it and does not come up with it. Pretty emphatic call from the officials. They're going to look at it.
Yeah, I don't know if I saw that hit the ground.
Not from that angle.
Might have to take another peek. It was Amari Okiki from Bellflower, California. They're taking a look at it. Here's another look.
Now, Mari's a JC transfer. Kanan playing because Olsen and Mazzotti are out.
That ball doesn't hit the ground, P.
Right at the end, it might have slid on it, but he did have both hands on it. Remember, the call on the field is incomplete. Right at the end, it did, but they're going to have a time looking at it, that's for sure.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed for an incomplete pass. Third down.
All right, and Dean Blandino agreed with you. He was checking it out, and he thought that ball may have hit the ground at the tail end there. So you're one for one, Petros. And Dean remains perfect.
And perfect hair.
Indeed. So third and four. Look at the timeouts there.
And they're really having a hard time right now. San Jose State is holding the edges against the rush of Daniel Greshick in particular. Really bearing down on Cordero on that last second down play. Here he is.
Showing blitz here is Utah State. End up just bringing three up the right sideline. Lockhart hauls it in. Tremendous catch for the sophomore from Los Angeles.
They get a little time for Cordero, and he delivers for them. Lockhart with a good step there against Michael Onyanwu. Onyanwu with the club there. on the left hand, trying to work him with the right hand. They're going to take a look at this one.
Yeah, San Jose State was trying to run the next play as quickly as they could, which is wise. They're just going to make sure that Lockhart made that catch.
Got right. Plenty of room on the sideline, stretches out. That foot's, if he has it when the left foot is down, it's a catch. But if he didn't have possession there, we'll know here.
I don't know. I don't know if he had control before that second foot landed.
Utah State coach is challenging the rule on the field of the catch.
What do you say, Dean? Was he in or out?
You know, I want to talk about my hair. You know, you guys are making a lot of comments here. I couldn't even give you a rebuttal. But this is a close one, and the key is going to be control. Does he have firm control with that left foot down? This is a great look. Does appear to get both hands on it. The left foot is still down. Now, this movement, is that movement within his control, or does it come loose? To me, he's still controlling it. He maintains that control. If I'm making this decision, I'm going to let it stand.
Especially with the call on the field being what it was.
Yeah, exactly.
I think that's very important. And, Dean, you've worked with me long enough. You know that I'm never going to say anything about your hair until your mic's been clipped, so you can't repeat it.
That's right. I know how you work, Dean.
Thanks, Dean.
Leave them open.
All right. Let's see what we have here. The call's been challenged. And this is a huge play because if San Jose State can get in there and score a touchdown.
Review, the ruling on the field stands of a catch.
There we go. Two for two.
And we talked about the way they started the half. They started the half hot. They were moving the ball. Cordero was throwing the ball downfield, taxing this Aggies defense. And they might be able to finish that way. And looking at everything that happened in between, Coach Anderson really got his team going, playing inspired defense and very meticulous offense. A lot of that could be erased on just two drives from the Spartans. And that young man, Shevin Cordero.
First down from the 29. Taking a shot up top. Catch is made. Elijah Cooks in traffic. And the flag on the play.
Just too big and too strong and too much proprioception, body control, awareness of where his limbs are.
This is a thing of beauty.
Yeah, and the safety
pass
comes over.
Number 22, defense. Yeah. That penalty decline. The result of the play is a touchdown.
Onyanwu tries to grab him. Hunter Reynolds comes over and knocks him over, but just a little late as Elijah Cooks. What a great target he is. And will be no complaints to Shevin Cordero from his roommate about targets, I think.
Terrence Shiva on for the extra point. This time it's good. So San Jose State with the second touchdown of the game, both of those courtesy of Shevin Cordero to Elijah Cooks. And this is a big score for the Spartans after what happened against San Diego State last week, in which they went up 14-0 and then saw San Diego State reel off score after score after score and then shock them 43-27. Had they gone into the locker room down 21-6, you got to wonder if that would be in the back of their head.
Yeah, that's a big shot in the arm for them on a cold night, feeling a little bit better about everything that happened after the first drive. And now, 1 minute left, Cooper Laga going to come out on the field. Aggies have one timeout. We know they have that very, very potent up-tempo style offensively, kind of two-minute offense all the time. But a nice response from the Spartans after really having trouble getting their engine started for quite some time.
A little pooch kick here. Caught it about the 27-yard line, and they're digging for the ball. They blew the ball dead. It was wrestled away by Parham, but see what they do here, because it sounded like they blew the whistle.
It did. Coach Brennan's looking to see what he can pull off.
I mean, they definitely ripped it out before he was down, but it's a question of when the whistle was blown.
It looked like Brock Lane was the guy that... If they rule forward progress is stopped, there's nothing anybody can do. Good heads-up play by Parham coming in and snatching the ball away.
All right, so Utah State going to have the ball with just under a minute to go and keeping it on the ground with Tyler. And the clock keeps moving.
Yeah, right into the backside of Jacob South. I think they were hoping he might be able to pop that and see if that could get their offense started, but only 1 yard. They're going to let the clock run a little bit and wait it out.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime Show, a Big 12 thriller in Waco, Big 10 collision course. We have some nice games coming up, and Georgia passes a road test, unlike some other teams in the SEC. Keeping it on the ground again, seemingly content to let this clock run out and go into the locker room with an 8-point lead. And don't forget that Utah State won the toss and deferred to the second half, so they'll get the first crack at it from an offensive standpoint here in the second half. So Utah State and Cooper Laga with an 8-point lead after one half of play. Special team stepping up, defense stepping up. Aggies feeling good. We're back after this.